sing thee, my Lord. Night and day, night and day, I look for thee, night and day.
Night and day, night and day, I look for thee, night and day.
Night and day, night and day, I look for thee, night and day.
Night and day.
Start the day with the Lord, end the day with the Lord.
Start the day with the Lord, end the day with the Lord.
Fill the day with the Lord, this is the way to the Lord.
Fill the day. Blessed immortal Atma, beloved arhats and seekers, devotees of the Lord, lovers of righteousness, satsangis gathered together in spiritual fellowship this morning. Third day of 9 days annual worship of Universal Divine Mother. Let us consider today a very simple, and perhaps due to that very reason, an oft bypass part of that, all life. But to which we pay not the attention that really merits. It's a very strange irrationality of human mind that what it accepts and even applies in one area of one's life is ignored, bypassed, or thought not very important in another part of our life. Many don't fail to give some sort of an exercise to the physical body. Jogging, swimming, some sort of system, or some system of daily dozen. Because exercising a faculty strengthens it. Develops it. This is simple reading. If someone does not use some instrument for a long time, it gets blunted at first. The more you keep it constantly in use, it's always in good shape, good condition. When it is not in use, sometimes sharpens it, keeps it sharp. If a car is left in the garage due to the owners being away for a long time, it tends to get run down, the batteries get run down, tires tend to get run. Therefore he tells someone, say once in a while, please take this out and give it a little run, at least a couple of days in a week, so that the batteries do not run down, car will not. Generally, see, get out of condition. We never think that we have more levels than merely physical level. It is not enough merely if you nourish the body, not enough merely if you do exercise for the physical limbs. We have moral muscles, we have intelligence. God has given. We should not think our cultivation of our intellect ceases with our college days. See, as long as we are compelled to make our homework, compelled to study, to answer an examination, we have to make effort and exercise our intellect. Once that is over, no more examination, no more homework. Well, we can just allow it to go by itself. We need not pay any attention. It will develop by itself. Why should it develop by itself? It should be neglected. Unless something is exercised, it tends to not to develop, not to grow, not to develop, not to become strong. Every aspect of our total personality must be kept engaged, must be given for. That is what keeps the development progressive, always ongoing. And also, exercising of any faculty makes it grow strong. This is the rationale behind abhyasa or sadhana. You need to exercise all faculties, physical body, mind, power of thought, concentration, power of intellect, reason, analysis, discrimination, inquiry, right inquiry. And equally, you need to exercise spirit within you. Spirit within you. Develop the bhava.
define the sentiments, the noble emotion. Everything actively exercise the spiritual awareness of your being, both by itself as well as in relationship with the universal. This constitutes all the aspects of the life spiritual, a constant series of awakenings, constant activity and exercise, keeping active spiritual awareness, consciousness. It's not enough just if you know once that you are an immortal soul. Afterwards, you think that things will take care of themselves. During the rainy season, weeds, ragweed, grass, thistles, thorns, they grow by themselves in abundance. In a short time, after a short shower of rain, everywhere you have this land. So much so, a gardener has constantly to keep removing them. Gardener has to be neat and clean, tidy, and the things which he wishes to grow should not be deprived of their nourishment by these silly things leaching away all the nourishment. And so that maximum nourishment goes to the roots to nourish the plants which you are trying to grow. Periodically, the gardener is engaged in removing all unnecessary growth and throwing them away. Thorns, weeds, all types of grass. So, this is one of the routine tasks of the farmer, removing unnecessary things. It will otherwise feed upon the nourishment meant for the In addition to putting special nutrients at the root of plants which he wishes to grow, he keeps on removing unnecessary, spontaneous growing. They are prolific. They keep cropping up. They have to keep removing them. And two, how careful the person who runs is a hothouse plant where he grows special kind of flowers. Special kind of flowers. You know the plot, he looks up carefully, tends to adjust the proper temperature, use the right type of nutriment, right quantity of water, neither less, neither more. Adjust the humidity of the hothouse, then he is able to produce beautiful special flowers which have a rare value. Fetch a good value in the market. Because they are special. Divine qualities, spiritual, requisite spiritual equipment, ingredients that are necessary for the life spiritual, for yoga, for prayerfulness, for concentration, for meditation, they are not ordinary qualities. They are special qualities. And therefore they have to be carefully cultivated. It is not reasonable or logical to expect that they will grow by themselves. If you know that they have to grow, then that's enough. That knowledge is enough that they will grow by themselves. No, they will not grow by themselves. They are not weeds. They are not just thorny plants. They are not just grass. They are not weeds. They are something special. You do not ordinarily see in the vast majority of people. So we have to make the requisite effort to cultivate, to take the care, to give the time and attention. I mean, take interest in yourself. See? we have to, above all, take interest in ourselves. If we do not take interest in ourselves, who is going to take interest in ourselves? No one else. This is not selfishness. You must know carefully. In the higher sense, if you take interest in yourself, you are doing two things. You are recognizing the worth and value of what God has given you. It means, I know its worth. I appreciate its worth. Therefore, I know attention is due to it. I have to pay attention. I must take interest in cultivation of this, because it is God given. Therefore, I, by the very fact that I take interest in its cultivation, I go to God, plainly prove that I do appreciate and I see the value of this. It has been given to many by the universal being. Secondly, in addition to appreciating and being token of gratefulness in taking interest, by taking interest in yourself, we are doing the duty by God's creation. God did not give these faculties just for ourselves only. If he has given us life and limb, it is supposed to be made use of for the benefit of God's creation, for all manner of beings that he has brought into existence. President Bush does not personally come to each state and each county and each city and each village and attend to things there. Police things and people, law and order, and provide medical facilities, provide education. He doesn't do it. But he does it through a machinery. And they do it in his name, in the name of the government, in the name of. So that authority, that position he holds, he functions through innumerable other people who represent that authority. So, each human individual is a representative of God. He is made his image. He has come here to bear witness to his power, his goodness, his compassion, his wisdom, his kindness, his purity, his truth, his light, his peace and joy. So we are expected to function also in this representative capacity. If the candle is lit, it's not hidden beneath a bushel. It is meant to be kept on a high place so that its light may scatter in all the 10 directions and help the travelers lighten up, remove darkness, lessen the darkness at least. This is why a candle is lit. If it is not lit, it may be lying in a packet. No one is going to blame it. But if it is lit, you keep a bucket over it. So, what is this? Which is the thing you are doing? The candle is lighted. It's meant to be shine. Meant to shine and meant to remove darkness. So, if he has sent us as representatives of his light, his divinity, his goodness, God in us, why not? We are expected to make light in addition to other things it is required to be. We are also expected to make life a process of bringing this out for the overall joy and happiness, welfare and benefit of this entire creation. This is a privilege that gives to us. Therefore, by our taking interest in our development, paying attention to our cultivation of our holistic personality, as I say, all parts of our being, physical, mental, intellectual, moral, ethical, spiritual, is the least that we can do to say thank you to God, to appreciate the value of what He has given to us. And to
see that these gifts are shared, are made the instruments of serving, benefiting, and of being useful to the creation that is brought into being and the immediate environments of where He has put us. Wherever you are meant to be a thing of beauty, a joy to others, help to others, a center of God's godly nature, a center of God's goodness. So that by looking at your life, they are able to recognize that there is some great being that is good. That is good. Therefore, it is not an act of selfishness if one takes interest in oneself, and one pays attention and takes time and energy in order to carefully cultivate oneself. Remember, God's virtues and graces, they are not like common weeds, thorns and grass that grows all around spontaneously by itself without our having to do anything about it, but they are like hothouse rare flowers. They have to be cultivated. Care has to be bestowed. Time has to be taken and attention has to be paid. It is also an art and a science. It is also a special area of personal development, the inner unfoldment of the spiritness. You go to a shop, you want something, and to get it, it is $5.95, you immediately take it and give. Anything you go, already you go equipped, whatever is asked you to. You engage a, hail a cab and engage it and take a ride to reach someplace, go someplace. Then when you reach, get down and immediately you take out the ride. How much? Okay? Everything outside in your life has a price and you very willingly pay it because you know. It's not something for nothing. Therefore, you are quite prepared. That's the way you are made to think. That's the way you function. That's the way your life lives. But why should we get the notion that in the life spiritual, things should just happen to us? Why not have the same attitude? Here also, there is a price to pay. And that price is called sadhana. And that price is called spiritual discipline. It's called the requisite effort to attain that which we wish to attain, which is attainable. Others have attained it, but through effort. While others were sleeping on the mountainside, this person was climbing up through the night also, getting ahead, ascending and moving towards the pinnacle. Therefore, Buddha in one of his sermons said, the wakeful amongst the sleepy, the vigilant among the heedless, the active amongst the indolent, such a one, O bhikkhus, indeed attains nirvana. The wakeful amongst the slumbering, the vigilant amongst the heedless, and the active doer of effort amongst the lazy. He, O bhikkhu, bhikkhus, verily attains to nibbana, nirvana. He stands to reason that any attainment requires that one who wishes that attainment puts forth the requisites, effort for the attainment. gain is not merely in this particular field, is not merely in proportion to the effort, 100,000, 1,000,000. Because the giver of whatever has to be given, for which we ask, we seek and make effort, he is not a niggardly giver. He is not a small thinking man. His treasures are inexhaustible. His treasures are illimitable, inexhaustible, infinite. Therefore, he takes your effort only as a token that is enough for him to shower his plenty upon you. Whereas here, in this outer realm, each one gets according to the quantum of the effort he has put. You get only just how much, what is due to you. There, you get what he starts giving. And what he starts giving, two hands are not enough just to take, because his bestowal is infinite. Therefore, but as a token, we have to understand that in as much as in this outer world, for everything we are very ready, willing to put forth the necessary effort, pay the price that is due to it. It is the same within, in the inner realm of our life, spiritual. We should be equally, or rather with more readiness, more eagerness, because we know the gain is a thousandfold. We should therefore know the necessity of taking interest in this development, in that development, and willingly and readily be prepared to put forth the necessary effort. And this effort is called sadhana, it is called abhyasana. In all those various factors that go to make it up, meditation, prayer, spiritual fellowship, study, worship, adoration, praising, glorifying the Lord. All these things constitute the very logical and reasonable process of giving the price or making the requisite effort. And the more special and more unique the objective which you wish to attain, the more special the effort has to be. The more special is the attention that you should pay. What a great deal of effort is made if you want to get gold, the diamond. Very elaborate effort. But if you want to gather some pebbles, you go to the river side and gather pebbles. There also you wanted something, you got something. But then because they are on the surface, that which is in the deeper depth. You take a pail and then go to a well, tie it to a rope and then get it. You go to the river and get some. But supposing it is somewhere deeper and it is not at the, I suppose you have to dig further and get it from the depths. So bring to bear your common sense and the reason that power of reasoning that God has given you. Bring to bear this faculty even in connection with the inner life, life spirit. What applies in the outer applies also in the inner. Therefore, knowing this, we should keep up our effort diligently, without flagging and without allowing our interest to become diluted. We must keep on renewing our interest with the same enthusiasm, with the same interest, with the same spirit, see, with the same aspiration. We should go on keeping up. It's worth the while. And this is what ultimately brings results. And all the while being aware that this energy, this whatever it takes, that we put forth is also given by Him. It's not something we need to come to conscious about. More you are able to put forth effort, more vigorously you are able to pursue an ideal, the greater gratitude you should give to Him, and more humble you should become, because ultimately all efforts are made possible by the Supreme Source of all power, force and grace. Thus, with gratefulness in your heart, recognizing that He is the Supreme Giver and the Doer, you must earnestly make effort without slack. The proper bhava, the same intensity of spirit, same enthusiasm, same great loving attention for our own highest good, fulfilling the great divine destiny that He has bestowed upon us, for which we have a birthright. Bless you. This is the sharing for today. Day of the Mother, today's pride upon this auspicious third day of the 9 days divine worship. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those that trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Adorable Lord of mercy and love, salutations and prostrations unto thee. Thou art omnipresent, omnipotent, and omniscient. Thou art Sachidananda. Thou art the evil of all beings. Grant us an understanding heart, equal vision, balance, mind, faith, devotion, and wisdom. Grant us in the spiritual strength to resist temptation and control mind. Free us from egoism, lust, greed, hatred, anger and jealousy. Fill our heart with divine meditation. Let us behold Thee in all these things and form. Let us serve Thee in all these things. Let us ever remember Thee. Let us ever sing Thy glories. Let Thy name be ever upon our lips. Let us abide in Thee. Sarvesham Svastri Bhavatu, Sarvesham Shantir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu, Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu, Sarve Bhavanatinah, Sarve Vandiramaya, Sarve Vandran Vishnitu, Ma Kasyantu Kabhad Bhave, Asadho Ma Svastri Gamaya, Tamasho Ma Jyotishyamaya, Vindu outside rises and sets as the light that you are is for all times, always, always. Day and by day. Maybe, if I can make it for what it would be, more helpful. Otherwise, for what I think. Because a lot of people taking leave and some things to do. And tomorrow, of course, they are having a different type of program. It's okay with all of you folks at 4 o'clock. Yes, sir. For us, for us.